Echo the Dolphin Underwater Donkey Kong Country Level Soundtrack Heaven Marble Madness Ball in a Maze Labyrinth Box Looking Son of a... You will undoubtedly shout even worse obscenities as you roll your way through this addicting puzzle game. Road to Valhalla. This is not the first game to put players in control of an independently moving sphere, but in my opinion, it does it better than anyone else. The controls are smooth, the physics are intensely realistic, right down to the weight of the ball you're playing as. The soundtrack doesn't only perfectly supplement the game, it actually becomes an interactive part of it. And the creator's sense of humor shows through in spades, bringing a playful element to the tedious nature of Valhalla. The object of each level is to collect the glowing yellow orbs while recognizing the patterns taking place between the obstacles and the beat of the music. Along your journey, you will run into white orbs which will replenish your health and serve as a checkpoint and respawn area, as well as a myriad of other things that don't really matter because the game will literally explain them to you as you encounter them. Valhalla at first eases you into a small taste of what's in store with the first couple of levels, and then they will pull the rug out from underneath you completely. When I find a good puzzle game, I'm usually ready to put it down after the first hour and come back to it later. Road to Valhalla was a fierce exception. I couldn't get away from it. The game not only gives you hell trying to get through each course, it also mocks you by placing smart-ass comments all over the field as you're attempting not to have your little marble obliterated by one of the endless types of death traps lying before you. The nicest thing about Road to Valhalla, though, would have to be you don't spend a lot of time sitting around figuring out the controls. I know what you're thinking. How confusing could it be when you're just a ball? The answer is very. It can be very confusing, okay? Especially when right is up and left is down and there's laser beams shooting out at you everywhere and you're trying to remember why the hell you opened the game in the first place! Then it happens, and you finally beat the level, and the gratifying memory of why you started playing comes rushing back to you. Never mind the fact that it took you 6,000 respawns to make it to the end. I'm giving Road to Valhalla a 4 out of 5. It's not the most original idea in the world, we've seen it done before, but it definitely approaches it in a new manner and gives you a lot of solid entertainment hours. Road to Valhalla is a game you won't regret picking up, even though you will have brief moments when you start wondering why you're playing a game that so relentlessly chews at your nerves.